One of the theme gardens that we'll be keeping this year is our ornamental grass garden. Olin and Teresa Thomas, who are volunteers out here, designed this garden, and they're ornamental grass enthusiasts, and it was such a great success last year that we want to keep it this year and show the progression of how they look after another full year's growth. However, Olin has advised us that this is getting a little overcrowded, and so we'll be transplanting some in a few moments. But right now, I've got some weeping lovegrass here that's due to be cut back. And I've cut the first two back, and I want you to notice that with any ornamental grass garden, things are usually planted in clumps of threes like we do with most perennials to give you a nice showing. But there is one chore you have to do, and it's usually done the 1st of March in Oklahoma, and that is to cut back the old growth. Now, it's not absolutely essential that you do this, but it makes for a tidier appearance. Certainly out on the tall grass prairie, they don't get cut back every year, but you still see nice green growth later in the season. But here, to give it a nice tidy appearance in the garden, you do want to trim them back, and you want to do this before they start showing signs of bright green growth. Now, if we look way down in here, there might be one or two stems just coming up that are a nice deep green, but we want to get to it before they start coming up through the old growth. Another thing to keep in mind is know which grass you're cutting back before you start the job. We have our handy label right here to tell us what these are. And if you come to the studio gardens later this season, you'll notice that we try to have everything labeled out here so you can identify plants and make plans for your own home garden. Now, in the ornamental grass garden, we have grasses of different heights. The weeping lovegrass is fairly short. We have other shorter grasses such as blue fescue. And then in the back, we have one that you might recognize if you're driving along the highway in Oklahoma. This is bushy broom sedge, and it's a selection that is very tall and feathery. Nice appearance. That too will have to be cut back in a little while. On back here we have some even taller grasses, and one of the favorites in the landscape, and one that you're seeing used a lot more in commercial landscapes, is Miscanthus. It's also called maiden grass. This selection grows to about 4 to 5 feet tall, and it too has to be cut back. Now, I've trimmed two of these already, and I've cut them back to about a foot tall, and the new growth will come up through that. We have one back here, though, that is getting overcrowded by the Ravina grass next to it. And so we're going to move that to another portion of the building. Now, with ornamental grasses, they require very little care, don't require any kind of insect control. You certainly do not need to fertilize them. In fact, most references on ornamental grasses recommend that you do not fertilize them so you don't get a lot of succulent growth. But they can get overcrowded after a while. I'm going to dig this one up. And we're not going to cut it back before digging, and I'll show you why in just a moment as we move over to our studio barn. Well, as you can see, this is an ideal time to be cutting these back. We have new growth coming up already. Look how thick this is. Nice green, healthy shoots coming up from the crown of the plant. And so in a little while, we're going to cut this back. Now, I've moved this to the northwest corner of our barn. We wanted a nice softening effect on that corner for when people walk up and approach the studio gardens. So we moved this Miscanthus here. And I've not cut it back yet because I want to see how it looks in place. Although you could trim these back before you move them around your property. Another thing you can do is you can divide them. Now, I want a nice thick clump here, so I'm not going to divide these. But as with most perennials, we've shown you how to do this a lot of times in Oklahoma gardening, you can just lay it on its side and cut through it with a real sharp knife and split it apart. Also, if you want to propagate these individual rhizomes can be cut off and propagated. So I'm just going to move this, kind of ease it on over into the hole. And make sure that's positioned where we want it. And we're fairly pleased with the height there and the positioning. I'll just backfill this. And then you want to water it in, of course, because it has been so dry here. And then, of course, the last thing you would do would be to cut this off to the right height to allow that new growth to come in. The one tip I might give you on ornamental grasses is sometimes they are at their most beautiful when they get a little bit of backlighting. This is against a building, and the only backlighting we might witness is in the afternoon, looking from the north side of it towards the west. But if you really love the glow that you get from ornamental grasses, consider placing them somewhere where they're going to let the light through once they start sending up their culms and blooming, and you can really enjoy them to their fullest. One last tip I want to make on ornamental grasses is don't mulch them. We mentioned not fertilizing, not overwatering, so you don't overly stimulate a lot of weak growth that would cause them to fall over. But also avoid mulching them, because that can cause the crowns to begin rotting after disease sets in. Remember that most of these are native to open prairie areas. They need plenty of air movement around them. Okay, the last thing I'm going to do is trim this back, and keep in mind that even though it seems like a lot of biomass that you're taking off, this is growth that can be reused again in your house to bring a little of the outdoors in. Keep in mind that with ornamental grasses, this is what a lot of people grow them for winter arrangements. And right now, Brenda is over in the shady part of our garden, and she's going to show you how to bring some spring into your home this time of year.
We hope you enjoyed this video. It's part of our OK Gardening Classics YouTube channel. You can also find more recent videos on our Oklahoma Gardening YouTube channel. And join us on social media for great gardening tips, photos, and discussion.